They love the applause. Okay, beautiful. Folks, judging today's non-sporting group is Mrs. Avery Gowden from Woodstock, Ontario, Canada, and her steward is, again, Sam McDonald. Folks, a little bit about the non-sporting group. The American Kennel Club originally registered dogs as either sporting or non-sporting. Eventually, hounds and terriers were split from the sporting group, and the toys and the working dogs were split off of that. Today, the non-sporting group is literally everything that was left over, resulting in dogs of great variety in sizes, shape, hair, function, and even history. For those of you standing in the corners, we have a lot of seats, by the way. Please feel free to come in. And the first dog is the standard poodle. The poodle is a very old hunting dog of unknown origin. Germany and France both had their poodles, but it was the French that made it their national dog. Poodles, remember, come in three sizes with one standard, except for the size. In this group, there is the standard and the miniature. The Dalmatian. This handsome breed gets its name from the province of Dalmatia on the Adriatic coast. He arrived in England when carriage riding was vogue and looked so good running along with the carriage that he became the official coaching dog. In this country, he transferred his skills to fire engines and remains famous as the firehouse dog. This is the Dalmatian number 5. Folks, this is a very, very new breed to Philadelphia. As a matter of fact, it's the first time this breed has ever been shown here. It's called the Xolo Itzcuintli. It's a Mexican dog and hairless. They're one of the world's oldest and rarest of all breeds. Xolos make excellent companion dogs, requiring minimal exercise, and as you can tell with no hair, very little grooming. This is Sholo H. Quinley, number five. The Tibetan Terrier. This dog has been raised in Tibetan monasteries for over 2,000 years. No dog of this breed could be sold, but only presented as a mark of enormous esteem. This breed is believed to be the ancestor to many other breeds, including possibly the Hungarian Puli. Tibetan Terrier. The Chinese Shar-Pei. The Chinese Shar-Pei probably dates back to the dynasty, about 200 BC. The country will result in his appeal as a companion animal. The Keeshound. The Keeshound originated in the Arctic, that much seems certain. Clearly the same strain that produced this breed was responsible for the Chow Chow, the Norwegian Elkhound, and the Samoyed. The Keeshound has been bred in Europe as a companion and watchdog for many, many years, especially on riverboats. Keeshound, number five. The Shiba Inu. The Shiba Inu, a fairly recent breed to American fanciers, has long been a popular companion and small hunting dog in Japan. It is a smart, foxy little dog that travels well and is loyal almost to a fault. It is bound to become much more popular as his fame spreads. The Shiba makes a fine watchdog, by the way. Shiba Inu, number 11.
it in the kennel, it doesn't matter. The kennel gets my sleep.
Now, Skipper Key. The Skipper Key is Belgium's little skipper or little captain. He gained his fame as a watchdog on canal barges. The skipper has since won broad acceptance as a fine little companion with an exceptionally long lifespan. Folks, this dog can live into his 20s. Skipper Key, number 10. The Bichon Frise. The Bichon originated in the Mediterranean area a very long time ago. The breed had early success in Spain and is believed that the Spanish sailors introduced breeding stock to the Canary Islands. In the 1300s, Italian sailors rediscovered this little dog. The breed became a favorite of Italian nobility and is now very popular here in the United States. Bichon Frise, number 15. The Lhasa Apso. The breed is an ancient one and almost certainly was named for Lhasa, the sacred city in Tibet. The lion dog, or Lhasa, was a watchdog in Tibet. Actually, he stayed inside where it was warm and barked to alert the Tibetan masters on duty outside. Traditionally, the Dalai Lamas gave these dogs as gifts in return for special favors. This is a dog of enormous style. Lhasa Apso, number 14. The Tibetan Spaniel. As its name implies, the Tibetan Spaniel does come from Tibet, but it stops there. There is no Spaniel in this dog, folks. Pictures of this breed appear on bronzes dating at least back to 1100 BC. This is a long-lived, hardy, and faithful pet. The first Tibetan Spaniel whelped in this country appeared on Easter Sunday in 1968. They have been gaining in popularity ever since. Tibetan Spaniel, number 14. the Boston Terrier. This breed, by the way, did originate in Boston in the area about 1870s and is one of the few breeds that really did start in the United States. He excels in agility, obedience work, and also as a companion and house pet. The Boston's personality has won the breed the nickname the American Gentleman. Boston Terrier, number 12. French Bulldog. There can be no serious doubt that the French Bulldog is descended from English Bulldogs. The features that distinguish this breed are its level skull and bat-like ears. This is a delightful family companion animal of British ancestry and became very popular here in the U.S. at the turn of the century. French Bulldog. The Bulldog. This breed is often mislabeled, folks. It's simply the Bulldog, not the English Bulldog. It got its name from the ancient and brutal gambling spectacle of bull baiting. The Bulldog's traits of courage and tenacity have made him a symbol of determination. Despite his tough guy good looks, he's a fun-loving dog and extremely affectionate.
Thank you.
Folks, in just a few minutes, the Terriers are coming out.